Hello boys, welcome back to another session of online biology video tutorials. And this session is meant for class 11th biology students, and this is meant for 1st July 2021. As all of us know, we have been discussing, analyzing chapter 2, biological classification. In that, we said that most accepted form of classification is the Whittaker's five kingdom classification. In that, for the last 2 days, we were talking about kingdom Monera and kingdom Protista. Now we go for the third kingdom, kingdom Fungi. And I'm sure you must have seen, now that it is rainy season, a lot of rains, and I'm sure you must have seen a lot of fungi, particularly that umbrella shaped one. Okay, if you're not seeing, see where there is a lot of moisture around your house. You'll see this agaricus. Okay, and fungi, of course, you just recollect from your memory that these are non-green organisms. They have very clear cut nucleus in their cells. So we say fungi are eukaryotic, achlorophyllous. There is no chlorophyll, achlorophyllous. And always they depend on others for their food, heterotrophic, spore bearing. If you touch that mushroom, that umbrella shaped structure, make it ulta and just see, there will be round structures. These are spores, spore bearing. Non-vascular, there is no vascular tissue, no xylem phloem, non-vascular organisms. And cell wall is important. It is made up of a special chemical called chitin, chitinous cell wall, or it is also called fungal cellulose. So kingdom fungi, it is a unique kingdom of heterotrophic, hetero, different, tropic, animal, different, they depend on other animals. They are cosmopolitan, they are everywhere. They grow in warm and humid places. Example, bread mold, orange rots, mushroom, toadstools, all this you must have seen. And particularly bread mold you must have seen in your own home if you are neglected. White spots on mustard leaves, you can see here. White spots on mustard leaves are due to parasitic fungus. And some fungi are the source of antibiotics. They are not only harmful, but they are very, very useful also, thanks to the discoverer of the most common and famous antibiotic, penicillin. Okay, and that penicillin antibiotic comes from a fungus called Penicillium. Some unicellular fungi like yeast, they are used to make bread, butter, beer, biscuits. You know, in your mess also, your mess manager will be using this yeast for fermentation. Other fungi cause diseases in plants as well as in animals, like in wheat, rust causing puccinia. Look at this, the wheat gets disturbed like this, and the basically Penicillium having this structure, spores, and yeast will be like this under high magnification. And except yeast, fungi are filamentous. Only you have seen just now, they are round. The yeast, their bodies consist of long, slender, you can see long, slender thread-like structures called hypa. The network of hypa is known as mycelium. Hypa are of two types, sinocytic hypa, where you can see many nuclei will be there. This is nucleus, this is nucleus, this is nucleus, this is nucleus, this is nucleus. You see, many nuclei will be present. That is sinocytic, multinucleated cytoplasm. Septate hypa, they have septa or cross walls. You can see the cross walls here, the septum. So this is a cross wall, this is a cross wall. Then we say septate hydra. Fungal cell wall is made up of, as I said just now, chitin. That is a special substance which makes it hard. And of course, polysaccharides. Saccharide means sugars. Many sugar substances will be there. Most fungi are saprophytes, means they absorb soluble organic matter from dead and decay substances. And some are parasites, as all of us know. Some live as symbionts. This is very, very important. Being a biology student, you must know that lichens are the indicators of levels of pollution in a place. This is how the lichens will be there on the stem trunk. If you happen to see that, that's an indication of the environment in which you are living. So algae plus fungi together is lichens. And fungi, when it grows on the roots of higher plants, then we say mycorrhiza. So these two technical words will be there for 1 or 2 marks. So remember that. Lichens and mycorrhiza. And how do they reproduce? Basically, fungi reproduce in 3 forms. Vegetative propagation, asexual reproduction, and sexual reproduction. If it is a vegetative propagation, the whole mycelium gets fragmented and each fragment grows into an adult, then we say fragmentation. There will be fission, that is spores will be fusing together, or the body will be breaking, fission. Basically, body breaking or cytoplasmic breaking is fission. Then budding, buds will be formed, vegetative outgrowths, and these will on maturity dehiscence and grow into an adult. And under asexual reproduction, we have got varieties of spores, conidia spores, sporangiospores, zoospores, and in sexual reproduction, another set of spores, oospores, ascospores, basidiospores. So this is how they reproduce. Now, as I said, fragmentation, the mycelia breaks up, you can see the fragments, and each fragment grows. Fission, in yeast, the first there will be, as I said, nuclear breaking, karyokinesis, followed by cytoplasmic breaking, cytokinesis. The body breaks into 2 parts, each part becomes an adult yeast. This is fission. In budding, there is an extra growth, external outer vegetative growth. This growth becomes in such a way that it forms a bud, and the bud gets detached from the parental body or mother cell and grows into an adult. This is vegetative propagation. Under asexual reproduction, by spores such as conidia, sporangiophores, and zoospores. So basically, the conidia will be at the conidiophore, the apex of the conidiophore. On maturity, they produce the conidia spores and they fall on the right place and they start germinating and produce hypa to mycelium adult. So there is no involvement of gametes here, asexual reproduction hence. And sporangiophores, again there is sporangium, and the sporangium will be forming the spores, and these spores grow hypa, and this hypa will become mycelium. So the only difference between conidia and sporangiospore is, there it is conidiophore, here it is sporangiophore. That is the only difference. Zoospores, motile, they have this, zoospores will have, you can see, cilia or flagella. So that's how fungi undergoes asexual reproduction through 3 types of spores. Coming to sexual reproduction, by oospores, ascospores, basidiospores. So here, they are produced in distinct structures called fruiting bodies. This is what they call it, fruiting body. So in sexual reproduction, it occurs by means of oospores, ascospores, and basidiospores. It involves what we call it as plasmogamy, fusion of 2 protoplasts. So you must remember here, plasmogamy. Gamy means fusion. What is fusing? Plasma. So fusion of plasmogamy. And then we have also got what is called karyogamy, fusion of 2 haploid nuclei. Karyogamy, karyon nucleus, karyo nuclear fusion, karyogamy will take place. And then there will be meiosis. So gametes may be isogametes, anisogametes, or oogametes. During sexual reproduction, 2 haploid hypae of compatible type fuse to form diploid cells, 2N. However, in ascomycetes and basidiomycetes, a dikaryotic stage, that is 2 nucleus two nuclear per cell occurs, and the condition is called dikaryon. Later, the cells become diploid. Deuteromyces are called fungi imperfecti. This you must remember. Deuteromyces are called fungi imperfecti because their perfect stages, that is sexual stages, are either absent or not known because of absence of sexual reproduction. They are called imperfect fungi. Some fungi show gametic fusion, while in some gametangial fusion, copulation are observed. So the phenomenon of having two genetically different and compatible sexual strains in separate thallus is known as heterothallism. This also you must remember, heterothallism. So this is discovered by Blaxley. So oospores, as you are seeing here, they're basically they formed from the fruiting body. And similarly, ascospores are also from the dikaryote hypa. Two carrions, ascospores are released. And then basidiospores, that is basidiospores, they are basically formed out of the meiosis. And then two strains will be there, that is male strain and female strain. And sexual reproduction, as we said just now, three types of sexual reproduction: plasmogamy, fusion of protoplasm of two motile or non-motile gametes; karyogamy, just now I said karyon means nucleus, fusion of two nuclei; meiosis in zygote, resulting in diploid spores. Like you have got this karyogamy, fusion of two nuclei takes place, n plus n, forming zygote. Zygote is a diploid cell. It undergoes meiosis, reduction division, forms spores. From 2n it becomes n. These spores will produce hypa, and this hypa will release the spores. So you have got a male and female spore, or plus strain and minus strain. So their plasma will fuse, protoplasm, plasmogamy, that results in again formation of zygote. So in sexual reproduction, two haploid hypae come together and fuse. In some fungi, fusion of two haploid cells immediately results in 2n, n plus n, 2n. In ascomycetes, basidiomycetes, a dikaryotic stage or dikaryophase, two nuclei per cell occurs. This condition is called dikaryon. Later, parental nuclei fuse and the cells become diploid. Fungi from fruiting bodies in which reduction division occurs, they form haploid spores, that is n number. Okay, and kingdom we classify based on the morphology of the mycelium, mode of spore formation and fruiting bodies. Fungi is classified into four types. So phacomycetes, ascomycetes, basidiomycetes, deuteromycetes. So these are the various characters based on which we classify fungi into four groups. So phycomycetes, they occur in aquatic habitats and on decaying wood in moist and damp places, or obligate parasites in plants. The mycelium is aseptate and cenocytic, multinucleate. Example, mucor, rhizopus, that is bread mold, albigo, parasitic fungi on mustard, all these come under phycomycetes. And lower fungi, it is called phycomycetes. The by motile juice spores or non-motile aplanospores, asexual reproduction takes place. These are produced in sporangium. Whereas sexual reproduction, it is fusion of two gametes from zygospores. So gametes are either iso means similar, and means dissimilar, oo means different spores. So sexual reproduction takes place. So ascomycetes, second group, it is unicellular like yeast and saccharomyces, or it can be multicellular like penicillium, thanks to we said penicillin. And mycelium is either branched or septate. Here you can see the branches, and septa also is there. They are saprophytic, decomposers, parasitic and coprophilous, that is growing on dung. And continue, by conidia, produced exogenously on the special mycelium called conidiophores. and this is how they undergo asexual reproduction. Conidia germinate to produce mycelium. By ascospores, produced endogenously, endo means inside, in a sac-like body, that's called assai. Assai are arranged to form ascospores. You can see the assai and the formation of ascospores. And then aspergillus, claviceps, neurospora, this is very, very good fungus, which helps in healing the wounds. Neurospora is used in biochemical as well as genetic work. And the clasp burster also it will be used. And the morels and truffles are edible and are delicacies. So these are all the economic importance of ascomycetes. Coming to basidiomycetes, it includes mushrooms, bracket fungi and puffballs. They grow in soil on logs and tree stumps and in the living plant bodies as parasites and causing rust and smuts. Mycelium is either branched, as you are seeing, or septate. The asexual spores are generally not found, but vegetative reproduction by fragmentation is very common. Sex organs are absent, but plasmogamy occurs. Plasma will be fusing. By fusion of two vegetative or somatic cells of different strains, this is important, different strain, plus strain, minus strain, the resultant structure is dikaryotic. It gives rise to basidium. And karyogamy and meiosis occur in basidium, producing four basidiospores exogenously. And basidia are arranged in fruiting bodies called basidiocarps. Example, agaricus, stilago, smut, and puccinia. You can see here the photos of that. And last, deuteromycetes, commonly known as imperfect fungi. This is repetitively asked question. Why? Deuteromycetes is considered as imperfect fungi because their asexual or vegetative phases are known. When perfect sexual stages were discovered, they were often moved to ascomycetes or basidiomycetes. So it is also possible that the asexual vegetative stage has been given one name placing under deuteromycetes and the sexual stage another name placing under another class. So when the linkages were established, the fungi were correctly identified and moved out of deuteromycetes. So why they are called the imperfect fungi? Because their perfect stages, sexual stages, are either absent or not known. That's how they are imperfect fungi. So deuteromycetes produced by asexual spores through conidia. And mycelium is septate or branched. Some are saprophytes and some are parasites. Majority are decomposers of litter and help in recycling of the minerals. So Alternaria, Collator, Trichum and